वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ गजाला चावलकर। टुडे अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द सेम चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 6, लैंड यूज, मॉड्यूल 2। सो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स हैव अ क्विक रिकैप ऑफ व्हाट वी हैव लर्न इन मॉड्यूल 1। वी लर्नड अबाउट द लैंड यूज, दैट इज इट इज़ द फंक्शन ऑफ लैंड, लाइक फॉर व्हाट पर्पस इट इज़ यूज्ड फॉर। देन वी ऑल्सो स्टडीड द टाइप्स ऑफ लैंड यूज, दैट इज टू टाइप्स ऑफ लैंड यूज, रूरल लैंड यूज एंड अर्बन लैंड यूज। सो रूरल लैंड यूज इट्स सब टाइप्स वर अरेबल लैंड, दैट इज द लैंड विच इज एबल टू ग्रो क्रॉप्स। देन फेलो लैंड, दैट इज the land which is not temporarily in use. Farmer keeps this land to improve the fertility of the soil. Then we also learn the forest land, that is a demarcated forest land is also used as a rural land use. Then grassland and pasture land, it is a large open area which contains full of grass and basically used for grazing purpose. Then also we studied about the urban land use, which includes the commercial land use, the land area which basically is used for business activities for generating profits. Then also residential land use, where people live, that is a residential zone. Then transport land use includes transports, railways, roadways, petrol pumps, service centers, etc. Public utility area includes services for public, that is hospitals, schools, universities, colleges, police stations, etc. Recreational land use is basically for recreational purpose, like these activities which includes which take you outside to the into the nature, which includes hunting, fishing, like we also includes entertainment purpose like swimming pool, parks, playgrounds, malls, cinema, theaters, etc. Mixed land use is a mixture of all these, that is commercial, industrial, residential areas which are together on one piece of land. So our learning objectives for today will be factors which are affecting the land use. It could be both a rural land use and urban land use, then transitional areas and suburbs, then planned cities, then ownership of land and ownership rights, 7/12 extract or 7/12 extract, and property card. Now the factors affecting land use. Land use means the way or purpose for which land in a region is used. The association between different geographical factors and man has resulted in land use. We see changes in the use of land after a certain period of time. The following are different factors which affect rural land and urban land use. So for the rural land use, factors like relief, that is the influence, the extent to which farm machinery can be used and the rate of erosion of the soil. That is, on very steep slopes, it is difficult to use modern farm machinery and such slopes are very subjected to erosion. Relief can also affect the land use through its influence upon the climate. Climate, that is amount of rainfall, too little or too much. Wind or sunshine. Soil, that is the mineral content, the mineral texture and depth of soil also affect the land use. Irrigation facilities, natural resources, government policies, that is the role of the government. The next one is the urban land use, location and site, that is how farness and nearness from highways or station. The natural resources, housing policies, transportation routes, like for example road, railways, airports. Next, industrialization, trade and commerce, playgrounds and entertainment facilities, and again role of government. The next one is the transitional areas. Students, first of all, what is the meaning of transitional? Now, transitional, belonging or relating to a change or the process of change from one form type to another. That is transitional. Okay. The rural settlement starts outside the boundaries areas of urban settlements, but the intermediate area in between is called the transitional areas. In this areas, there is a blend of rural and urban land use. In this areas, land use is of a mixed nature. In this zone, cultural activities are also of a mixed type. Over time, this area is converted to an urban area and these regions become suburbs. Now, what are suburbs, students? Suburbs is a mixed use or residential area existing either as a part of a city or an urban area or as a part of a separate residential community within commuting distance of a city. Students, for example, on the right hand side you can see here a picture given. Now this is a model of Ernest Berg's. This model was given by Ernest Berg's. This model was the first to explain why certain groups of people lived in a certain areas of the city. So you can see here the purple one, the arrow indicating the purple line is the transition zone. So transitional is the area between the factory zone and the working class zone in the concentric zone model of urban structure, which was devised by Ernest Berg's. It is the area where the land use is changing. Now the next one is the planned cities. After the Industrial Revolution, urbanization occurred on a large scale throughout the world. Since this urbanization was not well planned, cities began to grow in a haphazard manner. Because of employment opportunities, there a large scale migration to cities occurred. As a result, the availability of land is always a serious problem in cities. A lot of diversity is visible in the land use of cities. Limited land, varied land uses resulted in the thought of having a planned cities for the future. Even before a city grows, its land use is predetermined and a planned layout is prepared. Now, students, what is planned cities? Planned cities is a town that has been planned as a complete unit and built with the government sponsorship, specially to accommodate overspill of population, that is the large population. A planned urban community is designed for self-sufficiency and providing housing, education facilities, commercial, recreational facilities for its residents. For example, students, over here you can see in India, Chandigarh and Bhubaneswar are all examples of planned cities. Students, here we have few more examples of planned cities, that is Singapore, that is Switzerland and Washington DC. Now students, let us understand the figure 6.1. Now the given figure is a pie diagram or the pie chart. That is, the technique which is applied here is the pie diagram. So what is pie diagram, students? Here it is the circular statistical graphic representation which is divided into slices to illustrate numerical proportion. Now the theme of the given pie diagram is land use in Japan and India 2011. Here at the bottom you can see different shades have been applied for land use. For example, yellow for suitable for agricultural crop, red for permanent agriculture, green for forest cover, blue for permanent pastures, orange for others. So, you may have realized that in different countries, the percentage under various land uses differ. Based on the availability of the land, the population of a country, its quality and needs, land use types vary. For example, we can see here in Japan, the percentage of land under forest is more. And in India, the percentage of land under agriculture is more. Both the land use provide us a common produce, that is organic produce. Hence, the land is aggressively every year as per the need of the population. In India, major portion of the total available land is used for agriculture. So this shows that India's physiography mainly comprises of plains with fertile soil, and the Indian climate is suitable for agriculture. In Japan, major part is forest land. This shows that Japan is a mountainous region. The climate is suitable for preserving the forest areas. Now, based on Japan and India, the following are the basic factors which could affect the land use. That is location and site, industrialization, trade and commerce, government policies, climate, irrigation facilities, type of soil, natural resources. Now, students, next one is the ownership of land and ownership of rights. Now, first of all, what is ownership? Ownership means that it is a state or a fact of exclusive rights and controls over property, which may be any asset including an object, land or real estate or intellectual property. Or we can say ownership is the ultimate or exclusive right conferred by a lawful claim or title and subject to certain restrictions to enjoy, to occupy, possess, rent, sell, use, give away, or even destroy an item of property. For example, when I buy a car, I take ownership of it. It becomes mine. Or when I buy a house, I take ownership of it. It becomes mine. That is the state, relation, or fact of being an owner is the ownership. So students, as you can see here on the left hand side, we have a figure 6.2. It shows the 7 by 12 extract. It is also called as 7 by 12 extract. Now, what kind of land use is shown in figure 6.2? Now, in figure 6.2, rural land use is shown. Can you tell in which area the property is located? So the given sample is located at Vadzare village, Parner Taluka, that is Ahmednagar district. So under land utilization, we have seen how land is put to different uses. The ownership of land could be private or it could be public. Land registration in this context is done under the revenue department of the government. All the information about the registered land can be obtained from the revenue department in the 7 by 12 extract. Village form number 7 and form number 12 are combined to prepare as 7 by 12 or 7 by 12 extract. Hence, it is termed as 7 by 12 extract. So students, let us get some more information about this. One can get to know under whose ownership the land is from the 7 by 12 extract. The extract is a record which is kept by the Public Revenue Department. Serial number 7 and 12 are distinctive sections of the law pertaining to the ownership of the land. The 7 by 12 extract is a kind of a mirror about the land. This is because just by reading the extract sitting in one place, one can get a complete information about that piece of land without actually going there. The Register of the Revenue Departments records the details of the ownership rights of the family, status of debts and loans, transfer of ownership, and the area under different crops. These village forms are available with the Talati of every village. Talati students over here means the revenue officer. So these village forms are available with the Talati of every village for land and revenue collection purpose. Now how is this 7x12 extract read? There are two class in this, that is occupant class 1 means the land over which ownership rights are available through generation. This is the ancestral property. And occupant class 2, which means the land given by the government to marginal farmers, that is the small farmers or landless people. Such land can be sold, leased, pledged, given as a charity or transferred only with the section of the district collector. On the right hand side, students, all can see there is a details or contents of 7x12 extract. You can see in this picture we have different details showing the details of the 7x12 extract. Now the next one is the property card. Now property card is also called as PR card, which is the government certificate given to the owner of property. This is a proof of ownership of property. Malmatta Patrak or property card is a government certified property ownership title document in Maharashtra. In Maharashtra, property card is issued by local authorities to establish ownership in urban areas, while for rural area, 7x12 extract is issued. Students, this is the figure 6.3 on your right hand side, which shows property card. This is the urban land use, and the area which has been shown, that is a property shown here, is located in Bhandup, Mulund Taluka, Mumbai Sarp. Ownership of non-agricultural land is recorded on the property card. This document showing ownership rights and the area of the property is made available from the urban land records. It has the following information, for example, like city, survey number, plot number, amount of tax, area of the property assessed, right to access, etc. So students, the given graph, that is 6.4, tells you about the general land use and its changes in India 1990 to 2011. Now the given graph technique is the multiple bar graph. Multiple bar graph means the relation between different values of data, and students, you all can see here each column of the bar graph represent different land use. For example, light blue for forest, orange for non-agriculture, gray for pasture, yellow for other non-agricultural land use, then dark blue for fallow land, and green for total agricultural land. Now it is evident from the graph that total agricultural land use is maximum from 1990 2011. Due to this, India will become self-sufficient in the production of food grains and shall also be able to export it to other countries. Also, due to high percentage of agricultural land, it would also help to maintain the ecological balance. Study the given pie chart. Now this given diagram is a pie chart showing Maharashtra state land use 2010 to 2011. Now this is a pie chart. Pie chart means circular statistical graphic representation which divides into different slices to illustrate numerical proportion. In a pie chart, the arc length of each slice is proportional to the quantity it represents. Now we can see here different color shades have been used to represent the land use pattern. So it is evident from the diagram that 56.8% is under the area under crops. Then 16.9% is area under forest. Then non-agricultural land covers 10.2%, which is yellow in color. Then grazable and cultivable fallow land is gray in color. It represents 7.9%. And last, fallow land that is of orange color is approximately 8.3%. Now students, this image is in your textbook page number 41. Now the given all three figures are satellite images. Now what is satellite images? Satellite images are one of the most powerful and important tool used by meteorologists. They are essentially the eyes in the sky. These images reassure forecast to the behavior of the atmosphere as they give a clear, concise and accurate representation of how events are unfolding. Now this satellite image is of Monda village, Taluka Hinga, district Nagpur. Now it is evident from the picture one, we can easily see that in 2003 there is more of agricultural land and less of residential land. In picture two, in the year 2010, there is an increase in the number of houses and a drop in the percentage of agricultural land. Same as in the picture 3, in 2017, we can see that the percentage of agricultural land has dropped drastically and we can see more number of residential land. Now, let us have a quick recap of what we have learned today. We learned the factors which affect the land use, basically two factors, rural land use and urban land use. And in rural land use, we have climate, soil, type of soil, type of slope, irrigation, natural resources and government policies. Whereas in urban land use, we have location and site, housing policies, transportation routes, industrialization, trade and commerce, entertainment facilities and government policies. We also learned about the transitional areas and suburbs. Transitional, first of all, means belonging to a change or the process of change. Transitional areas means a portion of landscape that is adjacent to a natural or undisturbed area and is designed to ensure that the natural area remains unaffected by plantings and irrigation installed on the property. Transitional areas is the intermediate area in between rural and urban areas. Over time, this area is converted into an urban area. Suburb means it is a mixed use or residential area existing either as a part of a city or as an urban area. Next, we also learned about the planned cities. Planned cities is a town that has been planned as a complete unit and built with the government support or sponsorship, especially to accommodate overspill of population. Next, ownership of land and ownership of rights. Ownership means that it is a state or a fact of exclusive rights and controls over property, which may be any asset including an object, land or real estate or intellectual property. Village form number 7 and village form number 12 are combined to prepare as 7 by 12 extract. Hence, it is termed as 7 by 12 extract. 7/12 extract is the mirror image about the land. This is because just by reading the extract sitting in one place, one can easily get complete information about that piece of land without actually going there. The next one is the property card. Property card is also called as a PR card. This document shows ownership rights and the area of the property which is available from urban land records. It has following details like city, survey number, plot number, amount of tax, area of property assessed, right to access, etc. Thank you students for listening and watching my video, and I hope that you like my video. Thank you very much.